We are happy to welcome to the program right now former Prime Minister Brian Mulroney, who joins us on the line in Montreal. Mr. Mulroney, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
I appreciate this is such a sad circumstance that we are speaking right now. I'm wondering if you might share with us first and foremost how you're feeling at news that once a political opponent, but also a friend of yours, former Prime Minister John Turner, has passed.
Oh, I had a lot of respect for John Turner. We were friends in the mid-60s in Montreal for many years. And he went into politics in 62, 63, I think. And he was a star in Montreal. He was president of the Junior Bar Association, of which I was a member. And he was clearly a man destined for great success. Many people in Montreal, even in those days, saw him as a future prime minister. He was a brilliant guy, great lawyer, very successful, and he had, you know, he looked like a movie star. He was a great athlete, and so he had it all. And those who saw him going to the top were turned out to be absolutely right.
Just last year, there was a tribute dinner for Mr. Turner. He was 90 years old at the time. And you submitted a tribute to him. And in that tribute, if I'm correct here, you said, or at least you described him as a true gentleman of Canadian politics.
That is right. He was a rare person in Canadian politics because John Turner was effectively a true gentleman. He, you know, with John, there was... Look, I ran in two elections against him, and that's a tough business, as you know, for openers. The debate can get very, very brutal sometimes and heavy. But John Turner never believed in the politics of personal destruction. He never got personal. In fact, he was on a personal basis. He was very courteous and fair. And a pleasure to be with. And I think the fact that he was a gentleman set him apart from many in those days, and certainly for pretty well everybody these days, because politics has descended to subterranean levels now in terms of insults and personal attacks and abuse and so on. So no, John was a gentleman in politics, and that was fairly rare.
And if you allow me, I have my own recollection because I was watching the taping many years ago now, over 10 years now, of a program that was called Canada's Next Prime Minister, where it featured young people, and you were amongst the judges along with Prime Minister Turner at the time, and you had such kindness for him. He was obviously already in ill health, and you were so kind to him, and it was clear that you had a lot of affection for the man.
Yes, I did, and I had a lot of admiration for him. He had great natural talents, and he turned out to be, as you know, an excellent minister of justice and an excellent finance minister. And then he retired and went back to Toronto and came back into politics 7 or 8 years later. And he was a little bit rusty at the time when he came back, as we all would be. But I thought in the 84 campaign where he was doing well, he was 14 points ahead of me in the television, when we went into the television debates. But, you know, he was burdened down by that terrible deal that Mr. Trudeau made to appoint many, many Liberal partisans to the courts and the Senate and the commissions and so on. And he forced that upon John. And John had to carry that for the campaign.
Well, I've told you and told the Canadian people, Mr. Mulroney, that I had no option.
Well, Truman, your next question.
You had an option, sir. You could have said, I am not going to do it. This is wrong for Canada. And I am not going to ask Canadians to pay the price. You had an option, sir, to say no. And you chose to say yes to the old attitudes and the old stories of the Liberal Party. That, sir, if I may say respectfully, that is not good enough for Canadians.
I had no option.
Did he ever display any bitterness to you after that night of debate?
Not really. On election night, the first one we won, I had a long conversation with him. He called me. I had a long conversation with him and told him that that my sister Olive had helped win the Manicouagan for me, and his wonderful sister Brenda had won Vancouver Quadra for him, and he said, "I agree with you, Brian, 100%. But we went on to, he was leader of the opposition then for 6 or 7 years in the House of Commons. And while we had many battles, including, of course, the historic one over free trade, as I say, he was never, there was no malice in the man. There was no personal malice in him at all. And as you know, also, he was a man of principle. He was a very devout Catholic, a genuine believer. And so he brought a great sense of dignity, both to himself and to the various jobs he held.
Mm-hmm. How was his health in recent years? Of course, he was, until his death today, the oldest living prime minister in this country. How was his health in recent years?
Not good. He was still very courageous. He would get out, and I would see him from time to time at the York Club or the Toronto Club and places around town at various events. But you can tell he was functioning under duress, physical duress, because he had some serious ailments. But very courageously, he kept on going, and until I suspect the very last.
I wonder what you believe his legacy will be to Canadian politics.
Well, I think that it'll be his entire career. He was a great, John was a great House of Commons man. He believed in democracy. He believed in our parliamentary system. And in his career, he performed brilliantly in the high portfolios that he was given in various governments, particularly Mr. Trudeau's government, Mr. Pearson's government. He did extremely well. And as I say, he was a man of high principle, and he always conducted himself with dignity and with elegance. And so I think he's going to be remembered as of course, as a prime minister, but also as a parliamentarian who contributed a great deal to Canada in the course of a highly successful life.
You mentioned it in passing, but I'm hoping you might build upon the thought. What lessons do you hope current politicians, future politicians, take away from the career and the dedication of someone like John Turner?
Well, as I say, he brought to politics a very, very good mind and a vision for Canada. But, you know, he was married to Jill very happily with a beautiful family. And so he brought all those values, including integrity and dignity, to his job. He symbolized, I thought, much of what was the best about Canada. And I say that as someone whom he opposed in the House of Commons and in the debates and in election campaigns. And in spite of all of that stress and mutual attacks that go on in these things, I always held him in very high regard. And I think and hope that's the way John is going to be remembered by these succeeding generations, particularly the young people who are thinking of entering politics. They could do a hell of a lot worse, believe me, than to hold up John Turner as a role model.
Mr. Mulroney, I want to thank you for the time. I really appreciate the kindness of you joining us today.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And that is former Prime Minister Brian Mulroney, who joined us on the line from Montreal.